Hello people, in this video let us look at this ENT textbook by Hazarika, Nayak and Balakrishnan. This is a textbook of ear, nose, throat and head and neck surgery, it says, but this is mostly a reference book for undergraduate. Let's look at this book. So look at the contents here. As usual, ear, nose, pharynx, esophagus, larynx, trachea, head, neck, anesthesia, recent advances, right, instruments, practical, case, clinical case discussion. One thing you notice here is in ear, you have the embryology, anatomy, physiology, and then they are coming to history taking and clinical examination. And then they are going to the other things like hearing, assessment of hearing, hearing tests, hearing loss, etc. Let's look at these. So in embryology of ear, they're talking about the boundaries of the Prusak's space. Where is it? Here. Prusak's space, and here you have the malleus, and this is the handle of malleus. So what else is there here? What is this ring? Cross section of external auditory canal, the cartilaginous part. Okay, here they are showing the incisura terminalis anterior. Basically here the cartilage is absent. Here they're saying it is fibrous tissue. You know the incisura, right? This one, incisura, same thing they're explaining here. Look at the lymphatic drainage of pinna and external auditory canal. You have the pre-auricular nodes, posterior auricular nodes, mastoid nodes, and here they're talking about retro-auricular nodes. Let's go through some, what is this? Audiology and assessment of hearing, types of audiometry, a lot of audiograms here. This one is indicating what? This is, X is what? X is left. And what is circle? That is right. Unmasked air conduction. So here they are showing pure tone audiometry showing high frequency sensory neural hearing loss. Look at the classification of hearing loss. You have congenital, acquired, again that you have conductive, sensory neural, mixed. Here acquired you have organic, then you have functional, that's mostly psychosomatic, malingering, they're trying to lie. Hysterical. Okay. How's this book going, guys, so far? This is also saying that it has clinical and practical part. Otherwise, how do you compare it with Dhingra and other books? What do you feel? What is this? Hearing aid, post oral hearing aid. Different types of hearing aids. Okay. Okay, let's move on, guys. A lot of hearing aids. Yes, this one is a cochlear implant advanced bionics high resolution 90K Clarion. Are you getting echo from my voice? Okay, we have moved on to vertigo. Look at this. They have some question answer type of things. What causes vertigo? Contradictory information from vestibular system, visual system, proprioceptive system. So all of them are sending contradictory information to the brain. Let's go through some pages here. At the end of every chapter, they're talking about some points to remember. Now we have moved on to the nose and paranasal sinuses. What's there here? Parts of nasal septum. Here they're talking about the development of nose. Looks weird, isn't it? Like that to like this. So what are they showing here? Frontal nasal process, lateral nasal process, olfactory pit, median nasal process. So three nasal processes, is it? Median, lateral, frontal, then there's a maxillary process, mandibular arch. Okay. So like we told you, after anatomy and the physiology, they're talking about the history taking and examination of everything. Here it is of nose and PNS. This is showing adenoid hypertrophy in the nasopharynx, isn't it? And what is this image here? Coronal CT. Oh, this is osteomyelitis complex, isn't it? OMC means of paranasal sinuses, showing pan sinusitis. How are you finding the book, guys? Anything so special in this? It looks a little neat, you know, the way that it's printed, isn't it? What is this? House dust mite. So the chapter is allergic rhinitis. Middle turbinate showing polypoidal changes, okay, and this one is transverse crease below lower eyelid, Denny's line. Oh, there's a line name for this line, transverse crease below the lower eyelid. Okay, is it here? What is this? Allergic shiners, dark circles around the eyes. Yeah, something what I have. Orbital cellulitis secondary to fungal sinusitis. So we are still in sinusitis. So here they're showing secondary to this fungal sinusitis, this person has orbital cellulitis. So maxillofacial trauma, then we are in this chapter, sleep apnea syndrome. What is this? Endoscopic picture showing classical, this is the endoscopic picture showing the classical snorer's throat. So here you have the redundant mucosa of the uvula, the soft palate and the tonsillar pillars. Some redundant mucosa is there. What is this image? Pre and immediate postoperative pictures, lateral views show following external rhinoplasty for deformity following previous septal surgery. This person itself looks so different, isn't it? Pre and immediate postoperative pictures showing external rhinoplasty. External rhinoplasty has been done. So this person had deformity following previous septal surgery. Now it's fixed. Okay. So guys, what are we doing? We are looking at this textbook of ear, nose, throat and head and neck surgery by Hazarika, Nayak and Balakrishnan. We are now looking at pharynx and esophagus. So what's there here? Let's look at some interesting images. Grayish white patch over tonsils and uvula. So just a drawn image. I think they are trying to talk about diphtheritic pharyngitis. That's why they're talking about all this membrane or something. Look at this photo. It is indicating Vincent's angina. What is this Vincent's angina? Trench mouth. It is acute ulcerative lesion of the pharynx that involves one or both tonsils and usually extends. Okay, but what is it? Acute ulcerative lesion of the pharynx. Ulcerative lesion. Because of fusiform bacillus and spirochaeta denticola. So two organisms they are blaming here. So what is it? It is an ulcerative lesion, right? Acute of the pharynx. Turning a few more pages here. Adenoid hypertrophy partially occluding the left eustachian tube orifice. Partially occluding, okay. There's only one adenoid, right? Looks like, right? There is one adenoid mass, but there are two eustachian tube openings which are being partially blocked. Right? There's only one adenoid. Adenoid mass. Adenoid hypertrophy. This is a St. Clair Thompson's adenoid curette with cage. There's some cage here. Endoscopic view of small and large adenoid mass respectively. So this is a large mass. This is a small mass, is it? Okay. What is this? X-ray lateral view showing pre-vertebral space shadow widening with air fluid levels suggestive of acute retropharyngeal abscess. Is this the one? It's just looking too prominent. Pre-vertebral space, yes, before the vertebra, looks like. With air fluid level. So this is fluid and this is air, is it? Suggestive of acute retropharyngeal abscess. Note the straightening of cervical spine, which is a characteristic feature. So what do you think, guys, compared to Dhingra and Mohan Bansal? How is this book? What is this? Various intrinsic muscles of larynx and their functions. So they are showing all the functions. Okay, so if this is the vocal fold and here you have the arytenoid, contraction of the vocalis. So it is showing the muscles. There's only one abductor and that is posterior cricoarytenoid. Okay. Laryngeal examination showing subglottic stenosis. Yeah, see, laryngeal web in the glottis. This one is web. Laryngeal web in the glottis and this is showing stenosis. Stenosis is like narrowing, right? This looks narrow. So this is wide, but where is the web? The web is here. You see this? This is the web. This is also kind of nice. They're showing a laryngotracheal cleft. Tracheoesophageal cleft, laryngotracheal trauma, pre and post-operative pictures of endoscopic vocal lateralization with permanent lateral fixation technique. So what are they saying here? Vocal cord, they are lateralized, isn't it? With permanent lateral fixation technique. So this guy won't be able to talk much, isn't it? He can breathe nicely, but he can't talk well. But looks like they have lateralized only on one side, right? What do you think? And this looks more like a Reinke's edema or something. Okay, what is this? Prosthesis. See here, this one is slightly lateral. It's like paramedian, you can see. They're putting some cellistic prosthesis so that it becomes medial. So this is medialization of these vocal folds. Let's run through neoplasms of larynx, foreign body in the airway, so many gross images, rigid bronchoscopy, head and neck, okay, laryngeal crepitus being elicited. What is this, people? Ranula. That is a mucus retention cyst of the sublingual salivary gland, right? Sublingual salivary gland, mucus retention cyst. And this is the plunging ranula. Neck dissection in head and neck malignancy. Okay. Advanced topics. Methotrexate, chemotherapeutic agent. As usual, like many books, this one also is giving you a HIV manifestations and ENT chapter. And here you go with the instruments. What is this, operative specimens of ENT? What exactly is this? Epiglottis, arytenoid cartilage, array epiglottic fold, thyroid cartilage. The resected specimen after total laryngectomy. Oh, they removed the larynx. And what exactly is this that they're showing? T? What did they mean by T? Looks like it's not wanted there. T is actually the proliferative growth. The last section, guys, section 10 on case studies. Let's look at some clinical case discussions. They've given some 6 cases. So CSOM and recurrent rhinosporidiosis, bilateral ethmoidal polyp, CSOM, primary atrophic rhinitis, chronic tonsillitis, and with adenoid hypertrophy. What is TTD? Tubotympanic type of disease, right? CSOM, chronic suppurative otitis media. So they are telling you the case. This is nice, you can directly write it off if they ask you, right? Like they are giving you all the details. This person is a female, married, one child. Wow, so if you have case presentation, you can directly do it from here. But obviously examination you wouldn't have done, so you wouldn't get such a good clarity. But here they have put some photos also from the examination that they have done. What is this case? Endoscopic picture showing classical features of greenish crust. Diagrammatic depiction of the nasal cavity in present case. Which case is this? You write this atrophic rhinitis, right? So female, and they did all the tests. So provisional diagnosis, primary atrophic rhinitis with posterior deviated nasal septum to the left. Why do you say this is a case of primary atrophic rhinitis? Oh, they didn't answer it. Okay, you have to answer it. What are the types of atrophic rhinitis, etc.? So guys, we are done with this book. Interesting book by Hazarika, Dr. or D.R. Nayak and Balakrishnan. Textbook of Ear, Nose, Throat and Head and Neck Surgery. Clinical and practical aspects also are there. That's all for now, guys, in this video. We'll meet you in the next one. Bye-bye.